take it all as one big learning experience and make the most of it every single day. Hi guys, it's Christine. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm a recent freshman from Harvard University, now rising sophomore, which is very crazy, but I just handed in my last final yesterday, so officially done with freshman year. I will probably be doing a reflection video kind of on what I've learned once I've kind of wrapped my head around how to merge the two parts of freshman year. One where it's, you know, the normal college setting, and then one where, as you all know, we had to leave to continue the rest of the school year remotely at home. So kind of figuring out how to balance the two in such a video, but this is more about like those hard-hitting tips that I picked up from freshman year. The thing with these tips is that they're not the meaningful, like, you know, like try new things, always be yourself. Those are great tips, but I felt like this is something that would maybe be a little bit more useful, just things that I wish I had been more aware of from the very beginning. But yeah, let's get started. So first tip is learning how to manage your emails and your inboxes. So I ended up having to manage around 4 different emails by the end of the school year, just for different organizations and different things. So as you can imagine, that's quite a lot of mail that I have to look through. For the most part, I definitely ended up not reading all of the emails that I ever get, just because a lot of them are the automatic emails sent out by the university or whatever organization, things that ended up becoming just basically spam. So with that, there are 2 tips. One is set up folders from the very beginning. I had Gmail for 3 of my email accounts, so you can easily set up folders in those. And also for Microsoft, which is for my 4th email, you can also set up folders. Long story short, set up emails so you know how to divide up the ones that you feel like were worth going back to in the future. Maybe if you don't have time to read it, or if you want to go back to it, it has information that you want. You can figure out a system that works for you, but the biggest thing is just knowing how to organize it and knowing which ones to keep, which ones to delete. So make sure you do that as soon as possible, preferably towards the very beginning of the school year, and of course you can modify those folders as you go on. But the second tip is try to read and skim almost every email that comes into your inbox, especially the ones that come from like the random offices and centers at the university. Even though it might seem like spam, it's just, you know, like a weekly or maybe monthly newsletter of a bunch of random events. You just never know if it has something that maybe you might find interesting that you want to sign up for. Like for example, I'm signed up for the Mind Brain Behavior newsletter at Harvard. It's always like this monthly email where it's super, super long and very dense with a lot of information and notifications. And I know people would probably tend to skip over that, but I try to skim over it, at least to the very bottom, just once really quickly. For example, by doing that, I was able to sign up for a cool lunch where I was able to chat with a really famous neuroscience professor from University of Michigan, something that I wouldn't have been able to do if I hadn't looked through that email. So definitely make a point of at least skimming, because you never know what amazing opportunities you might be missing out on. So definitely keep that in mind. And the third thing, know how to write an email. That's definitely a really important tip, something that I kind of figured out for myself along the way throughout freshman year. You should know how to sign off on your emails. A lot of people use best, sincerely, best regards, nice, warm but formal signatures, no smiley faces, preferably no like exclamation points if you are talking to them for the first time, but usually once you get to know them you can do that. And also set up a good signature. You can set up an automatic signature that adds on to every single one of your emails that you send out. So college students tend to do it with their name, their concentration, and their graduation year. So that's something that I set up very quickly towards the very beginning of the school year, and it helps make my emails seem a little bit more professional, more put together, helps me look more put together. So little things like that, just things that I kind of take into account, but you can definitely Google search any other tips that people might have, because it's definitely an important skill. So that was a lot for emails and inboxes. The second general tip is have a good picture on hand. So the reason why you want a good picture, and I'll probably put up some examples, is you want to have good pictures on hand for if you're submitting maybe resumes, applications that are asking for a photo of you. Sometimes if you're participating in a club or something like that, they'll ask for maybe a picture of you to include in a bio on their website or Instagram, something like that. I found that it helped me to have pictures like that on hand, just because, you know, it's just a good like fallback. You don't have to scramble when the time comes. Often it comes up as a small item on your to-do list that you have to check off. It just makes life a lot easier when you already have it. I keep mine on my desktop, on my laptop, so it's easily accessible and I can quickly email it to whoever is asking for it. So that's something that I would consider looking into also as soon as possible. Try to get a good picture of you, something that's like not too casual, but definitely doesn't have to be like a suit and tie with a formal background. Keep it on hand. So I have it in my favorites, on my phone, and on my desktop, on my laptop. Third tip is use Google Calendar. I cannot stress this enough. Google Calendar is something that pretty much everyone in college uses. It's something that just makes scheduling events or meetings really, really easy. You're gonna wanna learn how to set up your own calendar or add other calendars. It will be your savior, I promise. I had to learn really quickly at the beginning of the year because I never used it before. I never had to use it in high school. I'd only ever used like an agenda or my bullet journal. So I had to pick up on it very quickly, but once you do, it's so easy to adjust. It was definitely, definitely worth it. And it definitely varies how people use Google Calendar. There are people who will use it to plan out literally every aspect of their lives, from the time that they're blocking off to eat or study, or just deadlines. Really casually, just deadlines every once in a while that they have to put in, or like maybe test dates. You have to find out what works for you, but I would suggest at least being familiar with it so you can make sure that you're keeping up with any clubs or other groups that you're joining in college. And the fourth tip, I don't know if anyone else says this, maybe just me, but save every answer or response that you write. And what I mean by that is I would often, you know, submit random applications for maybe club positions or opportunities to join in on this event, et cetera, et cetera. And a lot of times they would be asking kind of similar questions just because I'll be applying to things that are all pretty related in terms of my personal interests. Usually related to like newspaper writing, neuroscience, volunteering, community service. So a lot of questions will be like, why are you studying this? Tell us about yourself. Like, why are you interested in XYZ? I would usually be able to copy and paste the answers into the note sections on my laptop. And then if I'm ever writing another application, I would go back through my note section, kind of scroll through. And a lot of times, more often than not, I'll be able to find responses that were pretty similar to the ones that I should be writing for the question at hand. I could easily just copy and paste it and then tweak it around so that it actually fits the question. And it makes life a lot easier in terms of just tweaking it a little bit so that it's actually fitting the question that is being asked specifically. So at the very least, it's something to help you keep track of the things that you're applying for. But yeah, I do use it every once in a while to help me with writing new application responses if I am trying something else. And the fifth tip is it's okay to say no. You should learn how to say no because it's better than not saying anything at all. So something that I learned in college is that there are always going to be emails, texts, DMs from random people, from professors asking you to maybe do this or get involved in this opportunity to help them out, etc. It happens a lot and you know, you can't always do all of it. So if you really can't, and that's something that you have to learn how to decide for yourself, know your own time, your own schedule, your own priorities. If you decide that you can't do something, it's definitely better to politely say no. I know for someone like me, I hate disappointing people. I hate letting people down. So sometimes I'll just like kind of not respond and hope it goes away, but that's the worst thing you can do. You have to learn how to say, I must decline at this time. I am unable to commit to this. However, I appreciate the thought. Something that says it really politely but firmly. Always going to be better in your favor. They understand, they will understand. And if they get mad at you for that, then good thing you said no, because why would you want to work with someone like that? Definitely make sure that you're staying on top of little things like that, because all that does add up to your reputation-ish, just the way that people look at you and perceive you. So it's just the little things to keep in mind. Remember that as more and more opportunities come your way in college. And then finally, this is one of those like softer tips, but it's something that I definitely wish someone had said to me. You will not make everyone be your friend and you will not make everyone like you. Just deal with it. So definitely something that's really prevalent in college, especially towards the beginning of the school year as a freshman, is people are going to be going up to random people and trying to make friends. They're gonna be starting new conversations, introducing themselves. It's a whole big thing for at least the first 1 or 2 months of the school year. And it's just something that, you know, everyone gets used to. I will admit that for the most part, it's pretty easy to at least have a decent conversation. Maybe you won't be best friends, but at least after that, you'll be acquaintances. But there are definitely some moments where, you know, you'll approach them or they'll approach you, and then you'll quickly realize that they're just not interested. And sometimes it might be even a little hurtful. You know, someone like me, I'm pretty sensitive. So whenever those happen, I think about it for a long time and I linger on it and I wonder, what did I do wrong? Why didn't they like me? What could I have done better to get them to like me? It's just not everyone's going to get along, and it's fine. It happens. You just have to brush it off. That's something that I learned the hard way. Not that I did anything bad to people, but I could tell that there are some people, you know, maybe who didn't want to talk to me. I'll admit I've had conversations like that where I maybe didn't want to talk to them. It's nothing personal. It's just, you know, we don't click, and there's nothing wrong with that. You have to make sure that you keep that in mind. Please keep that in mind and don't let it get to your head. And another added thing with that is it's okay if your friends at the beginning of the school year or even at the beginning of the semester aren't the same as the end. And it's okay if you don't have a solid friend group that, you know, everyone's jealous of. Your experience in college in terms of the friendships and relationships that you form, it's going to be specific to you and personal to you. Everyone is on their own path, and so you just have to remember that no matter what, you're putting your best foot forward. And that kind of goes along with all the other previous tips that I just gave. Take it all as one big learning experience and make the most of it every single day. That's the best thing that I could advise. And hopefully if you're watching this as a rising freshman, or maybe even in high school, maybe in college right now, looking back on freshman year, hopefully you can take any of these tips. If you have any more, definitely leave them in the comments. I want to make this a great community where we can all help each other, because college is such an important part of our lives if you do choose to pursue it. So hopefully you guys are all doing well, staying safe and healthy, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Bye.